Mr. Z is going to love this one, right? So will Dr. T. He's going to love this. Now, I understand that, you know, the dude whole math, he tried, you know, I got to give white folks credit, man. They try to change it just enough so it's not plagiarism. And shout out to them. So the whole math did it. They changed a couple of the levels and stuff like that to make it look like an original idea, but our favorite four, and you know who that is, old Stefco, right, Mr. Z? So I'm listening to her talk about relationship theories, and so, you know, I'm just have YouTube on, and then she talks about Tinks, and she talks about the box theory. I said, that sounds kind of familiar. And Tink's box theory is talking about dating, right? That now she shifts the boxes a little bit. Like she said, the man will have nothing to do with you, will hook up with you just for hookups, and the highest box is girlfriend. So I think whole math pretty much has the same kind of boxes, right? So I'm thinking, I said, damn, that sounds familiar. And then she says, when a guy meets a woman, quote unquote, that a woman's going to have a hard time moving from box to box, right? Because a man knows what he wants out of her. And a woman should know how she stands. I said, yeah, I said, that sounds really familiar. And as she's talking, oh, shit. I said, Dr. T, you know, shout out to Dr. T. He told me, man, you should write these books and write this stuff down, so that it'll be a record of it, because people will bastardize and steal the ideas. And with me, man, I think that it's just an insight, and I don't think it's world shattering or anything like that. I think it's just, when I have come up with an idea, it's just a simple solution to a problem, right? So the box theory, it always has three levels. So I listen to Tinks, and Tinks is on all these shows, and she's doing all these interviews. One, because she's female, too, because she's white, you know. And I know I'm an old black dude, and that nobody listens to, that most people don't like, including YouTube. And I know I give away a lot of my intellectual property for free, because it's something that I did to help people. The people that were around me, right? And this is something, the three levels is something I came up with in 2008 or so. I think it was like 2000. Yeah, because it had to be, because the other show I was actually joined came in 2009, and I already had come up with the idea. 2007, 2008. And there was a dating coach that was on Facebook that I used to be Facebook friends with. I used to listen to her podcast. And she told the story about, and I think I've told this story before. She told a story about the women that she coached, that because she was a marriage coach. She was a relationship coach. She was a marriage coach. She tried to guide women into getting married. And she had a lot of clients that would come to her, said, and this is very common, I dated this guy for 4, 5, 6, 7 years, and we broke up because he wouldn't marry me, and 6 months to a year later, he married somebody else. She told that story constantly, over and over and over again. And I heard other dating coaches refer the same sentiment. I heard a lot of this kind of stuff on Facebook. And my sister, this is what triggered it. She said the same thing. One of her best female friends, had dated a guy. She had dated a guy for 4 or 5 years. And after they broke up, he married somebody else. And the question came back, why? Always come back, why? Why would a man take a woman through all those years, use the best years of her life, blah, blah, blah. And then when it comes down to marry, they marry a completely different woman. And so I went out and investigated, right? So I worked around a lot of people, a lot of guys, a lot of females, a lot of guys. So I knew why I did it, but my experience was my experience. So I asked everybody else. So girl, I'll first ask you, especially the married guys, what made her qualify to be your wife? Why'd you marry her? How long did it take? Blah, blah, blah. And most guys, I would say 90%, they married that woman in a year or less. 90%. So there's the outliers. It took longer than that, but most guys married that woman within a year. And outside was 3 years. Very seldom you see a guy get married to a woman outside of 3 years. I've they dated each other for 5, 6, 7 years and got married. Those are pretty much outliers. They don't happen that often. Most guys marry, when they see a woman that's a wife, they marry fairly quickly, right? So then I've been around other guys that I thought that they were probably gonna get married, and then they were girlfriends for a long time. And then after like, you know, 6, 7, 8 years, you see a, you know, in a break area crying. Why are you crying? And find out they broke up. And then guess what? That dude, within a year, he's married to somebody else. So I finally pieced it together by asking questions that men don't see time as a qualification. If you ever hear a woman about she's with a guy, it's always the length of time that she's been with that guy. I put in 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, however many years that it is. And I should have graduated to the next level because I've been with him and stood by him for this many years. I remember this famous court case, the Maglica case, the guy that invented the mag light. He was with his girlfriend for 20 years and never married her. Never married her. For 20 years, he didn't marry her. This is quite common. The length of time is not a qualification for a guy. And it's always qualifications of the nature of the woman. His qualifications, what he wants out of that woman, whether she's as Chase calls it, a hookup, casual sex, a girlfriend, emotional labor, emotional stability, emotional effort, emotional ties to the girlfriend. And then for the wife, financial ties. I'm willing to accept her as a financial burden. I'm willing to take that risk as a financial burden. Those are the three levels. So I'm just cracking up about dating. about the box theory. A woman cannot move from box to box to box. And she's trying to explain this. She's trying to explain this without using my material. Listen to when Home Math tried to explain, he's trying to explain it without using my material. And I was cracking up. So I may send this to old Stefco, man, because the box theory. The box theory of dating. But one thing she did say that was correct. You have to evaluate where you stand. You have to evaluate to where you stand. If that man doesn't emotionally take you under his wing, say you're a hookup, say you just met, and say you met on the internet and you went out on a couple dates and you slept together. And as long as you guys are together, you guys get along, as long as it's fun, right? But within the day-to-day stuff, the day-to-day emotional stuff comes, then it doesn't work out. You are not a good girlfriend for that guy. If you're together and you look at him after a couple days and you can't stand him, or vice versa, he doesn't like you, then you're probably not going to be a good girlfriend. You don't qualify as a girlfriend for that guy. You're not emotionally stable for him. If that woman doesn't know your work schedule, or she doesn't pay attention to your needs, or you don't pay attention to his needs, you don't qualify for that guy. You're not into him like that. You're a casual partner. If he doesn't emotionally start depending on you, if he's trapped or he's got a blown tire and he needs somebody to come give him a ride and he doesn't call you, you're not a girlfriend. You're a jump off. You're casual. You're not part of his life. If he doesn't claim you, then you're not a girlfriend. at the next level. I always tell a woman no more than 3 years to be a wife. A guy knows within 6 weeks, Kevin says 6 months, that you qualify to be his wife. He's just looking for gotchas. And after about a year, if being married is what you intend upon, she should be seeing you as his wife. You should bring it up. You should bring it up. Definitely by 2 years. By 3 years, you should be out. Should be out. It might be uncomfortable, but if for whatever reason you do not qualify for his wife, and you should listen to his complaints, because it will come out. It's something that he does not like about you, and it's a deal breaker where he can't marry you, it'll come out. And I tell all women, by year two and a half, if he ain't start proposing, if he's not talking marriage, if he's not telling you why he can't marry you right now, he's not giving you any kind of feedback on why or why not he's not going to marry you, year three, you don't qualify. And it's nothing personal. Stop trying to change his mind. And don't have a baby for him, because that shit doesn't work. But those are the three levels. And I was blown away, because I had never heard of the box theory. And as soon as I heard it, I said, oh, shit. But Doc was right. It's my fault. I should have put it down on paper. Doc is 100% right. He said, man, somebody's going to take this if you don't put it down on paper. And they will not be able to relay it to the same degree that you do. And he's right. I listened to her box theory. I might even read the book, The Box Theory, to see what she says about it, about dating. Because I'm really curious about it, what she put down. And how she actually used it. I saw what the Home Math did with it. He actually did a better job. He actually did a better job. But they didn't show the graphs or the timelines or nothing like that, right? That's I had slides. I probably still got slides from when I did it. I think I put it up on the channel, on the YouTube channel, maybe 2013, 2014. Maybe 2014 I put it up on the channel. And I know I put it up on a blog. I think it was 2012 or so. I put it up on a blog. One of my personal blogs, I put it up there. So it's I know I wrote it down in like 2011. But it is hilarious, man. It's hilarious. I think, hey, man, you know, this is so common. Anybody could come up with this, man. I said, man, when they steal. So shout out to Rollo Tomasi. Well, I give Rollo credit. Anything he comes with, he writes that shit down and puts a time stamp on it. But this shit is hilarious. The only person that I always fed stuff too, because I wanted him to use it, was Kevin. I always fed stuff to Kevin, man, because I wanted Kevin to actually almost like be my mouthpiece, because I knew he could actually broadcast whatever ideas I had much further than I could. So I always cheered Kevin on, man, and said, man, because he asked me about octanes, he asked me about sign language. I mean, he made it his own though, so. But it just kills me, man. You know, I'm not an academic, man, but this idea game, this intellectual property game, is vicious. It's really vicious. But anyway, shout out to Mr. Z. Listen to old Steph Co. And I might send her this. I might make one for old Steph Co., man, and send her this about the box theory or the three levels, so that she can get a clear idea of exactly what it is. Because it's actually hilarious. But as far as, I don't know why people make dating so hard. I don't know why people make dating so hard. I mean, I guess it's, you know, I thought that dating apps would simplify the process, man, but it seems that the dating apps just made it harder. But I guess, you know, the fundamental skills have eroded to where people are too afraid to get rejected and afraid of meeting people in person. People are afraid to actually go out and actually, you know, guys are afraid to go out and holler. And women are actually afraid to actually receive that attention on the street. It's a weird thing, but I don't know, man. You know, maybe I'm getting old. Maybe the times in the landscape have changed considerably. But the brothers actually use fundamental processes and use the same old fundamental game, get better success. They still do. They still do. In fact, I think the brothers that are old school and know how to get things done, the old school would have is probably a superpower now, because it's old knowledge and it's forgotten. Much like Star Wars, when Obi-Wan pulled out the lightsaber, talking about it's a weapon for a more elegant age. It's probably one of the most powerful weapons in the galaxy, but the knowledge of it had died. So just having that knowledge gave you superpowers. Anyhow, and with this, I just thought I would record this, man. The box theory. I said, I couldn't believe it when she said that, man. And I looked at her, I said, this is a real thing. This is a real thing. I said, just say, gone, white girl with your bad self. And she looked nervous when she was trying to explain it. Jeffrey, you know you stole that shit. Anyhow, man, let me get out of here. BGS out. I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.